Zakaria GPS, seen in Sunday morning 10 Eastern and Pacific.
We've been tracking it. They managed to get independent, but there's always been a fear, one, that they will be undermined from by the North by effectively militias or secret military raids of various kinds. And the second is that the North will try to broker a kind of deal on the oil sharing, on the revenue sharing, which is deeply unequal. What's going on?
It's a big question. We're at a very delicate stage right now. There was a referendum in January. The South approved independence by 99%, and they defied expectations. I mean, let's give them some credit here. The referendum was on time. It was orderly. It wasn't very violent at all. These are people who are not running the referendum, are not that well educated, had no experience doing something along this, you know, along on the scale, and they did it really well. Now is the tricky part. Now the country has to separate. In July, they're going to declare independence. Sudan is going to split in half. There's a million issues to solve, the border, the oil, ethnic issues, citizenship issues. You can't just draw a line through any country and say, you're one people, you're another people. These people have intermingled for centuries.
And the oil is in the South, but the North wants basically half of it.
Most of the oil is in the South, and it has been driving the Sudanese economy. And all of a sudden, they're going to have to make do without this huge revenue source. So I was there a few weeks back, and we went to a border town called Abyei, which is emerging as a flashpoint. It's almost like the Jerusalem of Sudan, because both sides claim it. They both have historic ties, and nobody's going to be happy. No matter what arrangement they make, somebody's going to be very unhappy. And right now, nobody knows what to do with this area, with Abyei. They're sort of pretending, you know, that everything's going fine, but we've heard, you know, we've gotten reports of more military, more soldiers building up, tanks, helicopter gunships, all flowing into this area in preparation for what could be, you know, a major confrontation. So I'm a little worried, because I think a lot of the focus has been, a lot of focus has been put on Libya and the Middle East and North Africa and Sudan, which is a fulcrum in that part of Africa. And what happens there is going to affect the entire region. And then we just have a few months to go.